Elon, this was your chance, your opportunity to make us all proud. I thought last night I would go, oh, look, watch this thing go up. And I'm like, why is it going in the opposite direction? Wasn't it so cute on Robinhood where you have the buy button, but the sell button just wasn't there?
Yes, I'd like to speak to Vlad, please.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, the buttons are missing. No. I'm not calling in regards to GameStop. That was my last call. Yeah, you removed the buy button. I was trying to buy. Yes, okay, I'll hold.
And what I want to do is I want to travel back in time. I want to go way, way, way back. And so we don't make the same mistakes, you know? They say you probably learn from your mistakes because we keep going through cycles. We have four-year cycles, and then we have four 30-year cycles. We're going to dive into that because we want to learn from our mistakes. Look at this. Robinhood crashes. Oh, hey, has that ever happened before? Huh? No, first time? As Dogecoin plummets 30%. This is not the first time the financial trading app has crashed during periods of high volatility. Looks like this image from Robinhood. Can't even make that up. You want me to zoom in on that crashed image for you? Here, let me see if CNBC has good images. Dogecoin plunges nearly 30%, but I'm sure as of filming this video, you'll be like, but now it's up 5,000%. As Elon Musk's SNL appearance, I would probably say it was, what's the word I'm looking for? And I guess it's a sentence, not a word. I was left wanting more. Not like Miley Cyrus over there on a wrecking ball where she gave too much. But I thought, hey, maybe this could be a really good teachable moment for the youth or the elderly or whoever it is. But no, Bravo, you need to have diamond hands. I'm like, no, I got cotton candy all over my hands. I'd rather be, you know, licking it on the way up, licking it on the way down. Like, don't you guys want to buy things on sale? I mean, my wife's great at that. She won't even look at the amount. She's like, I got it. I saved X amount. I saved $1,000, which is frightening because then you're thinking, how much was it? And this is not the chart that I wanted to look at. That's actually Bitcoin. I want to look at something else. So the first chart I want to show you guys, I have arrows. Look at me. Now look at the chart. Now look at me again. Now look at the chart. This is silver. And when it comes to, right, diamond hands? No, this would be silver hands. I am just going to accumulate. And I think you're going to learn a lot from this. Because if you don't understand taking profits, that's actually a very big problem. Right now, if you guys are trading stonks or you're trading crypto, you should know where the sell button is. You just should. Get comfortable with it. Because there will be a, you should be, and anyone that I know with sense, YouTubers, they get it. They know how the cycles work, and they take profits. Back in 2010 in silver, you can see the chart. There's some people still holding bags, and it's been 10 years, and it's heavy. And they're still, they put $1 million in, and it only says $500,000, but they will wait. Now, here's the problem with the buy and hodl. Oops, let me delete that. And let's go back to the other people that come before you, like me, that have been holding, well, I have not held bags since the 1970s at over $121 an ounce. That's 40 years of waiting. And that $20 from 120, looks like a lot of charts I've been seeing recently. Would it not be wise to accumulate at the bottom and start selling on the way up? But herein lies a problem, and it's with psychology. It's emotions. People run towards, yay, it feels good. That's pleasure. They run towards that. So when any crypto, you know, fill in the blank stock starts pumping, it feels good. Let's do it. And then when it dumps, it feels bad. So people sell it. They run from fear and they run towards pleasure. And I'll tell you, the banks figured it out long, long time ago on how to manipulate markets based on that fear and pleasure. What they will do is they will put in an order to sell Whatever. It's all, you know, it's derivatives. They can come up with any number that they want. $1 trillion. Let's dump $1 trillion short silver. And what does that do to the price of silver? Well, everyone runs away. And then the people that stay with their diamond hands, they file lawsuits and the banks lose. But they still keep doing it. And now crypto comes on the scene. Now this is kind of crazy because now it's almost like whack-a-mole. Like, which one is it? They don't know what to do, how to manipulate this. This is getting a little crazy. They're like, do we go after Bitcoin? Do we go after Doge? Like, there's too many, Bob. They just keep popping up everywhere, which is actually a good thing. Now, with Bitcoin, you have a four-year cycle, and you need to know this. There's a time to accumulate, well, for me, or a time to swing trade on the way up, me, and there's also a time to start selling towards the top. Four-year cycles. Let me show you. Year number one. This is great because we are currently in the year number one, right? Year number two, retracement. Three and four, accumulate. Year number one, it's just like repeat. Year number two, retracement. Year number three and four, accumulate. And the process continues. We have what's called the halvening. Supply gets cut in half. And every 4 years, the cycle returns. Now, from this chart, the next image, and he did this, I think, maybe 6 months ago, a year ago, I don't know. He's just calculating, just moving on down, and I think he's going to get pretty darn close to cycle number one, Bitcoin hitting between 100 to 150, somewhere in that range. But then a retracement to somewhere around 40,000, and then everyone runs away, and then everyone starts accumulating in the 40s. You know, these are years, guys. You have to think, can I go through 3 to 4 years of a retracement? And have you been taking profits on the way up? Especially when it comes to altcoins. If it is altcoins, that would be, you have Bitcoin, and then everything else is altcoins. You should be taking profits in the next coming months. And I think so many people just have these arbitrary numbers. I'm like, when are you going to sell? I don't know, maybe when it gets to, right? Like, no, there's no TA involved. You just come up with a number. When Doge hits a dollar, or when Doge hits $10, well, that's when I'll get out. Well, you could be holding bags for a very long time. But based on this cycle, I think there is safety right now. You guys are safe. So enjoy this one-year cycle. Now, looking at Bitcoin, it's nice to be able to dive into some technical data and figure out, huh, what's the probabilities of me making a lot of money or losing a lot of money? Now, on Bitcoin, I have two patterns that are currently in play. One, rarely anyone uses. It's not even in a playbook. It's called a diamond pattern, and it's typically probabilities. It breaks to the downside. Now, how much? Well, you'd be measuring from the top of there to the bottom of there, which is about 25%. Now, bearish pattern number one. I need to pause this. I think we're in a bull market. Do I own any Bitcoin at 65,000? No. I went fully in on the last break. We had a rising wedge. And I explained on this channel, I'm like, all right, hit the bottom. We had a double bottom. I accumulated on the way up to our next rising wedge. And let me turn off some of my wonkiness so you can see. And this is now on the 1 hour. We see it a little bit better. You see the double bottom? That was a go for me. If I were to change this also, if you want to see it a little bit more simply, and this was a beautiful V. Look at that. I say, when things hit those deep Vs like that, why, Johnny Bravo, does it always have to be funny? That was my entry point. And I think, not financial advice, you will lose 100% of your money. Go listen to those other YouTubers that tell you to leverage on Bybit 100 times. So that way, when you get stopped out, you lose 100 times of your money, which you will never see me have a link in the description for Bybit. No way. That's an easy one, though. Hey, you guys, you get $5,000 just, you know, spin the wheel down below. I personally need to sleep at night, so I think I have to teach you. Now, you get this all for free on YouTube. I do it every single day. I go through any stocks, crypto, you know, gold, silver, you name it. People throw rocks at my face and they're like, no, diamond hands. But if you want to learn how to do this, link in the description. It's a $1,000 course and I knock, it's what, $349. That in my book is a good discount. And I promise you this, I will always add to it and I will always increase the value, which also increases the price. But oh my gosh, these guys with their Bybit links, they make millions of dollars. I just can't do it. And there's so many people out there and I do my best to try to protect you, right? I actually had a meeting with this guy. Wanted to go over some things. Him and my daughter. Not getting into it right now. Right? I'm the guy. I'm trying my best over here, you guys. A 25 billion Dogecoin whale lurks. Can I give you guys a warning? Like, the waters are dangerous. And at the end of the day, I just don't want you to lose money. I want you to, like, make money and be happy, even though money probably won't do that, even though I've never seen a guy on a jet ski not smiling. I mean, from the richest men in the world, Bezos, Gates, divorce, unless, hey, you got something up your sleeve, you know? Taxes, something? What? Am I missing? But for these guys, it's like, how much is enough? You couldn't spend it.
Yes, but I'd need to keep more of it.
But this guy is so rich, he needs a yacht to support his yacht. Look at this, you little stud. Look at that. Oh my gosh. A super yacht, okay, to support his, and you know what? Is this gonna bring you happiness? Yeah, you bet your bottom dollar it will. Imagine how many of your fake friends that you can impress with, like, come on out unto the seas. You and I shall drink, and then I shall push you out into the sharks. Oh, hey, look, a few of them. Great whites. Hey, goodbye, friend I didn't like. And coming in from this guy, Mr. Bobblehead, Mad Bunny. Don't overreact to the stock's post-earning decline. All is good, because the market can be wrong, Kramer, and so can Kramer. But that is why we momentum swing trade, and we take profits off so we do not have to hold Jim's bags at the top. And I know I said there were four things. I said I was going to talk crypto, and then I was going to talk stock market. Well, you already got a little bit of taste of the stock market. And oh, and sorry about that thing that's going down with oil. Shocker, right? Didn't see that one coming. Well, it's a hack. The fourth tourney, if you guys ever get a chance, buy me this book for $300. That's all it is. I used to sell books. The most I ever sold a book for was $800. I used to do that. I sell on Amazon my whole life. Well, what, 20 years? Have I been selling on Amazon for 20 years? $300 for this book. Now, let me explain this. And I will do it with circles. Here we go. Four 30-year cycles. Congratulations. And it just repeats forever. You go all the way back to the forever. And we have good. We have the meh, okay. And then we have the not so good. And then we have the really bad stage. Use bad words like war. Back in 2008, guess what? We started the bad stage. So we're about, the good news is, right? Because on this channel, it's about good news. We're about halfway through, but it's gonna get a whole lot worse. So that's what is happening now. And I just wanna make sure that you guys are not all holding the bags at the top these next 15 years. Well, until 2038. So we got some time. We have some time on our hands. Just be careful. Because when all of this breaks, yes, you see? And you see it, like you could kind of start to see the pieces. You got the reset coming, you got the debt, it's already here. You got GDP, which is, you cannot be at 130%. Sorry, you gotta fix it. You got to change this. Just whatever you do, don't think that next year is going to be like this year, right? They're like, oh, 2020, that was horrible. 2021, you're like, this is worse. But also, maybe it's the calm before the storm. I mean, all of these things are building and governments are going to tear it all down. So hold your breath, but just not too long, because I want to see you tomorrow, and I'll see you tomorrow.